Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tutorial based on your requests. In one of my last YouTube videos, one of you guys left in the comments down below a request to create a pinup style look in Photoshop. And today we're going to do exactly that. We're going to be creating what you see here in front of you, and hopefully you can take these techniques and apply them to your own projects to get the exact result that you're looking for. So to begin, I'm going to be using this photo right here, which as always I found over at shutterstock.com. Now the first thing that we need to do is we need to extract the model from its background. Now you may be happy with a pink background, but for this case, I'm going to be changing the background to a little bit of a darker, older style feel. So how do we extract a model from the background? Well, there are a lot of ways to do so, but it usually starts with a selection method. And one of my favorite selection methods is the quick selection tool, which you can find in your tools bar on the left, and it's hiding with the magic wand tool. I'm going to go ahead and select the quick selection tool, and it works almost like a brush. You can use the left and right square bracket keys on your keyboard to increase or decrease the size of the brush. And all you have to do is brush on top of the model, and you're going to notice that it's starting to make a selection over the areas that you brush on top of. And what's nice is it detects the edges of the areas that you're brushing, so it doesn't select anything that shouldn't be selected. Now, on occasion, it will select some areas like this pink in the background, and in that case, you hold down your Alt or Option key, and you select, and it deselects that area for you. Then you can go ahead and refine the edge. So I'm going to continue to go around this model, and the nice thing is it doesn't have to be 100% accurate. In a moment, we're going to be using the Refine Edge tool in Photoshop to make the selection as accurate as possible. All right, so now that our selection is complete, we want to make sure to refine the edge so that we have a nice, accurate selection. Now, there are two ways you can get to refine edge. If you have a selection method active, you can find it on the top on your options bar, or you can also find it under the select menu at the top of your workspace and go down to refine edge. Now, in this window, we have a few ways to preview how our selection will look. Under the View menu right here, we can choose Marching Ants, we can choose On Black, On White, Black on White, all these different preview methods. But again, it's just a preview, that's not how it's going to look in the end. But the feature we want to focus on is Edge Detection. We're going to turn on Smart Radius and increase the radius just a little bit. And you'll notice it's gone around and made a much more accurate selection around the edges, especially where there's hair and fur. Now in this case, there isn't too much hair and hopefully not any fur, so we don't have to crank up the radius too much. But if there are areas that it missed, you can always use the Refine Radius tool and brush in the areas that you want Refine Edge to focus on, especially hair and fur. So I'm just going to do one very simple pass around the outline of her hair, just in case it missed any stray hairs that should be there. And there we go, that looks good. So our selection is looking pretty nice, pretty accurate. And once it's done, you don't want to press OK. You want to make sure to change the output to New Layer with Layer Mask. It's very important that you save it with a layer mask, because if you look down here, there's some areas that look a little bit funky. And in that case, you can always grab the layer mask, and with a black or white brush, you can always make some refinements. So with a black brush, I can make it a little bit smaller. I can easily brush over this area that looks a little bit strange. And this area here kind of got rid of some of the legs, so I can use a white brush and paint that leg back in, just like that. Switch over to black to get rid of this area. Switch back to white to paint in some of the area that it got rid of. I can go over here and do the exact same thing. Switch to black and get rid of some of the selection that it missed. Switch to white and paint in some of that leg. You get the idea. So let me go back to 100%. And now we have our model extracted from the background. And now it's time to create our new background. So to start, we want to create a new layer. I'm going to go ahead and select the background and create a new layer right at the bottom. And we want to choose a yellowish brown color, somewhere right around here. I'm going to set that to my foreground color. And now that it's the foreground color, I can use my Option Delete or Alt Backspace shortcut to fill that layer with my foreground color. And once you have a new background set, again, you can see the importance of using a layer mask. There are some areas that still look a little bit weird, so I can grab my layer mask one more time and just make some very minor adjustments. And I can always go back later on in the edit and make some changes to it if necessary, but I like getting those out of the way at the beginning. All right, we'll leave it at that for now. It's not perfect, but it's not bad either. Good. Now going back to the background, we're going to be adding a few filters to kind of give it an authentic old style feel. Now before you go ahead and start adding filters like a wild person, you want to make sure to convert this layer for smart objects first. This will ensure that you can go back and edit those filters later on if you decide you don't like them anymore. And to do that, you can either right click on your layer in your layers panel and choose convert to smart object, or under the filter menu, convert for smart filters. Either way will do the exact same thing. And once it's been converted, we can start adding our filters non-destructively. The first filter we're going to be adding will be a texture. I'm going to hop into my filter gallery. I'm going to go down to texture. I'm going to choose texturize, and I'm going to set it to canvas with a scaling of around 50%. Maybe I'll increase that just a little bit. Let's say 80% and relief about 2. I want it nice and subtle. And when I press OK, it may look a little bit tiled if you're not zoomed into 100%. But if you zoom into 100%, you should be able to see that it's a nice canvas style texture in the background. And finally, the last filter I'm going to be adding, I'm going to hop back into my filter gallery, head up to brush strokes, and I'm going to choose a spatter texture. I'm going to keep it at 25 and 15 and press OK. It kind of gives a little bit of an older feel, and some of the adjustments that we're going to be making in the next few minutes will add to that even more. So let me zoom out just a little bit so I can see my whole entire document just like this. And we want to add a new layer. We're going to be adding some burn marks to give it even more of an older feel. And to do that on the new layer, I'm going to make sure to set my foreground color to black. And I'm going to grab a nice large brush. So I'm going to right click to bring up my brush picker, make sure the hardness is at 0, and set the size nice and large. Let's say somewhere around 1000, maybe a little bit lower. Right around there, 737, perfect. And once your brush has been set, all you have to do is start painting around the edges where you want the burns to be. Just like that. Now it looks a little bit ridiculous. That's because we haven't blended it yet. To do that, in your layers panel on the right, we're going to set the blend mode, change it from normal to overlay. That'll blend our black brush with the background layer. And you can always go back and make additional burns if necessary, just to give it a little bit of an older feel. Just like that. Perfect. Our background is complete. Now it's time to move on to the model. There's a few things we're going to do. We're actually going to be making 3 copies of this model. One's going to be for a blur, which we're going to add a little bit later on. And the other 2 are going to help give our model an old style colorized feel to her. So to make our duplicates, we're going to select our model layer. I'm actually going to change the name of this to model. And with the command key on the Mac or control key on Windows held down, press the letter J key on our keyboard twice. And that will give us 3 copies of our model layer. 1, 2, and 3. We're not going to worry about this one too much because this is going to be our blur. We're going to get to that a little bit later on. But these 2 we're going to focus on right now. I'm going to hide the top one just so we can see what we're doing on the bottom layer. And I want to take out some of the saturation in this model. She's a little bit too vivid right now. So to do that, I'm going to be adding an adjustment layer. And again, adjustment layers further add to the non-destructive editing that we've been doing this whole time. So at the bottom of the layers panel, I'm going to click on the adjustment layer icon and add a vibrance adjustment layer. Now from here, I can either adjust the vibrance or the saturation. In this case, both of them will work nicely. If you're looking to increase the vividness of your photos, you definitely want to do vibrance if you're dealing with skin tones. But in this case, because we're decreasing it, either vibrance or saturation will work nice. I'm going to leave it right around negative 34. That looks pretty nice right there. It's not too vivid. It's also not too desaturated. Okay, so now that that layer has been dealt with, we're going to move on to our top layer. This is the layer we're going to be adding some filters. And again, before you start adding filters, you always want to convert it to a smart object right here. And once that's done, the first filter we're going to add, I'm going to hop into my filter gallery, head up to Artistic, and I'm going to be adding a poster edges filter. Now for this filter, I want to make sure I have a nice outline around her body and a little bit of posterization going on. So the settings that probably will work well will be 1 for the edge thickness, 1 for the edge intensity, and 2 for the posterization. Now, the nice thing again about using smart objects is that if you need to later on, you can always hop back into your filter gallery and make the necessary changes if needed. But right now, I'm going to keep it as is. Now, you may like this look the way it is, and you may want to keep it the way it is, but for this edit, I'm going to blend it a little bit with the previous layer. And to do that, I'm going to change the blend mode of this layer from normal to soft light. That'll blend it just a little bit, very subtly, with the layer right below it. And now the last filter I'm going to be adding will be noise. So I'm going to go down to filter, noise, and then add noise. Now, most of you will probably have the amount set pretty low and you probably won't be able to see it. It's because we have the blend mode set to soft light. So you'll probably have to crank it up somewhere around 25 for that noise to start coming through. You want it a little bit subtle, but also enough so you can see it. So it kind of gives a little bit more of an older feel to it. And that looks good right there. If I turn off the visibility of this layer, you can hopefully see what these two filters have done for this layer. Good, now the last layer we're going to be working on will be the blur that will go underneath and beside her. So I'm going to select that back layer right there. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit. Now before I convert this layer to a smart object so I can start adding filters and transformations, I want to make sure to fill it with black. So black right now is my foreground color, so I can very simply hold down Alt or Option and press Delete or Backspace to fill it with black. And if I move it out of the way, you can see that indeed it has filled in with black. So now that that's done, I can go ahead and convert it to a smart object. Again, right click and convert to smart object. Now at this time, I can start my transformations and my filters. So to enter free transform mode, Command or Control T on your keyboard. I'm going to drag it down just a little bit, right around there. And then I'm going to hold down Command and Shift, Control Shift on Windows, and drag it to the side. Perfect. And once I'm happy with the positioning, press return or enter on the keyboard, and then you can move it into place if needed. I'm going to move it right there just so her hand lines up right about there. Perfect. So now for the filters, I'm going to go up to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. And I'm going to add a very subtle, somewhere around 5, maybe 6 pixel blur. Press OK. And now to finish the blur off, we need to fade it out and decrease the opacity. So to fade it out, we're going to add a layer mask at the bottom of the layers panel. And then grabbing the gradient tool right over here in the tools bar, we want to make sure that the gradient is set to black to transparent. And then very simply brush down just to fade it out just a little bit. And then finally decrease the opacity to blend it in with the background. There we go. That's looking pretty nice. The next element we're going to be adding will be the text. Now the text really is completely up to you what it looks like. I'm going to be using a script-based text. I'm going to be using Snell Roundhand. I'm going to make it nice and large, set to a dark blue desaturated color. And I'm going to go ahead and type out my words of choice. That's a little bit too small, so I'm just going to transform it up just a little bit, or quite a bit. Press return or enter to accept the changes. Now I do want to blend it in with the background just a touch. So I'm going to zoom in here so I can see it at 100% nice and crisp. I'm going to enter my layer styles and down at the bottom, I'm going to use blend if to blend it with the background very subtly. So I'm going to hold down Alt or Option, Alt on Windows, Option on the Mac, and drag the left side of this handle to the left just a little bit. And you can start to see that it's very subtly blending with the background. Obviously, if I go very far, it's going to blend a lot, but I want it very, very subtle, somewhere right around there. And press OK to accept. Perfect, we're almost finished. There are two more things we're going to be doing which are completely optional. One of which is to add some sort of a grunge map on top. Actually, it looks like there's a face right here. You see that little face? Anyways, ADD. Adding a grunge map can further add to that old feel to your design. So I'm going to go ahead and drag this into this design right here. And once it's on your document, I'm going to hop back into my layer styles dialog box. And again, down at the bottom in the blend if section, we're going to make a few blending changes. This time we're going to be affecting this layer, not the underlying layer. I'm going to drag the left side of the highlight slider to the left, and you're going to start to see some of the brighter areas of this grunge map start to fade away. Just like that. And then finally, you can change the blend mode to either overlay or soft light, whatever you feel works best, and you can decrease the opacity if needed, just to give a little bit more of a grungy feel to this design. Press OK. And finally, the last thing I love to add to most of my designs, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, is a curves adjustment layer. It really starts to sharpen up your image just a little bit. I'm going to pull this up a little bit, pull the shadows down a touch, highlights up a touch, maybe a little bit, and leave it right around there. And there we have it. We have our pinup edit complete. And because we worked non-destructively, all of this is completely editable. So if you want to go back and change the vibrance, maybe decrease the saturation of the model just a touch, you can easily do that. If you want to change the texture of the background, you can very easily do that. You can change the blending of the text. Everything is completely editable, and you're left with a pretty nice looking old style pinup. And again, you may not be looking to create exactly this, but hopefully the techniques you learned in this tutorial, you can take those and apply them to your own projects and create exactly what you desire. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure to leave your comments below as to what you would like to see in a future Photoshop tutorial. Hit that like button and make sure to check me out at iceflowstudios.com. Take care.